Lung cancer is the leading cause of cancer-related mortality worldwide, with 1.7 million deaths in 2015. Cancer develops when healthy cells become transformed and acquire cancer properties, such as uncontrolled cell division and the ability to escape normal cell death pathways. Small cell lung cancer, SCLC, is the most aggressive type of lung cancer and accounts for 15% of all lung cancer cases. In 90% of SCLC cases, the cancer has already metastasized upon diagnosis, and 95% of patients die within 5 years. Dr. Leslie Sutherland's lab at the Health Sciences North Research Institute focuses on understanding how a certain family of RNA binding proteins influences SCLC. A greater understanding of SCLC will lead to more effective screening and treatment options. Early on in almost all SCLCs, there is a deletion in the region of DNA which is close to the RBM5 gene, which encodes the RNA binding protein RBM5. RBM5 is a tumor suppressor gene. Such genes protect healthy cells from transformation, and mutations in these genes often lead to cancer. The Sutherland lab previously found that lower RBM5 levels might be a key step in lung cancer development. Cell proliferation decreases in SCLC cells that express RBM5, and the cell's sensitivity to chemotherapy agents increases. RBM10, another RNA binding protein, is in the same gene family as RBM5 and is mutated in 20% of lung cancers. It has been suggested that RBM5 and RBM10 may have similar functions and that RBM10 may also be a tumor suppressor gene. Sutherland's team set out to compare the functions of RBM5 and RBM10 and to learn more about RBM10's role in cancer. Based on previous findings and their similarities, RBM5 and RBM10 were hypothesized to have overlapping functions in downregulating pathways associated with transformation. Sutherland's team used RIP sequencing technology to identify RNA molecules which RBM10 binds, called RBM10 targets. They previously used a similar strategy to identify RBM5 RNA targets. They found that RBM10 has almost 7 times more RNA targets than RBM5. About half of RBM5's targets were shared by RBM10, suggesting only partial overlap in the roles of these proteins. They also showed that RBM5 can even bind only one specific version of RBM10 RNA. Furthermore, using RNA sequencing, they determined that RBM5 and RBM10 influence the expression of similar genes, but in opposing manner in SCLC cells, suggesting opposing functions for RBM5 and RBM10 in SCLC. Remarkably, the researchers found that RBM10 actually promoted cell proliferation in SCLC cells that don't express RBM5. Altogether, their results suggest that RBM5 might regulate the function of RBM10, and that RBM10 is free to exacerbate cancer progression in tumors that don't express RBM5. The research has identified important new features for RBM10 and sheds light on the role of RBM10 in cancers that don't express RBM5. This is important because RBM5 is altered in almost all lung cancers, especially in SCLC. The work might also help us to understand neurodegenerative diseases and developmental diseases such as TARP syndrome in children, where mutations in RBM10 are implicated. In future, the group will try to further unravel the involvement of RBM10 and RBM5 in cancer and other diseases. RBM5 and RBM10 might be useful biomarkers to determine SCLC risk in cancer screening programs. Restoring RBM5-related functions in cancer cells might represent a new way to improve SCLC treatment.